Hello and welcome to Dr. Anima Upadhyay's chemistry lectures. In this video, I would like you to help how to answer the questions asked in theory paper correctly so that you can score very good marks. We will be discussing about the questions that could be asked under the chapter fuels and combustion. Whenever you are writing the answers in chemistry paper, you should always give the examples, write the equations, formulae, and draw the figures, whether it is asked or not. Irrespective of that, you must give these things. Also, wherever it is required to write the units, don't forget to write the units. If you will not write these things, you may lose the marks. So let us start with the questions and see how they should be replied. What are chemical fuels? How are they classified? Now this question contains two parts. First part is what are chemical fuels, and the second part is how are they classified. So first you will reply the first part, that is, what are chemical fuels? The substances which on burning in air produces enormous amount of energy in the form of heat and can be utilized in doing some useful work are called fuels. Examples of fuels are wood, coal, charcoal, natural gas, crude oil, water gas, producer gas, oil gas, petrol, diesel, kerosene, etc. Here I have given you a long list. I hope you will remember at least 4 to 5 names as examples. Now coming to the second part. How are they classified? They are classified on two bases. Chemical fuels are classified on two bases. First, on the basis of occurrence in nature, and second, on the basis of aggregation. Now you will first write on the basis of occurrence in nature. The chemical fuels are classified into primary chemical fuels and secondary chemical fuels, and give the examples of each. Primary chemical fuels examples are wood, coal, crude oil, and natural gas. Secondary chemical fuels examples, charcoal, petrol, diesel, water gas, producer gas, oil gas. Next basis is on the basis of aggregation, that is, states of matter. They are classified into three types: solid, liquid, and gaseous fuels. But all the three types can be further written as primary and secondary solid fuels, primary and secondary liquid fuels, primary and secondary gaseous fuels, giving the examples for each, such as primary solid fuels, wood, coal; secondary solid fuels, charcoal; primary liquid fuels, crude oil; secondary liquid fuels, petrol, diesel; primary gaseous fuels, natural gas; secondary gaseous fuels, oil gas, water gas, producer gas. Another question: what is the difference between primary and secondary chemical fuels? Now you have to write the difference between the two things. So you will write the definition of primary and secondary chemical fuels. Primary chemical fuels definition is the substances which can be used as such in the way they are present in nature as fuels are called primary chemical fuels. For example, trees. They are cut down and the wood which is obtained from the trees can be used directly as fuels. Similarly, coal, crude oil and natural gas are the examples of primary chemical fuels because they are present in the nature and we can use it as such without treating them as fuels. We can use them as such as fuels without treating them. Secondary chemical fuels are the substances which are derived from the primary chemical fuels. So, charcoal is produced from coal. By the destructive distillation of coal, we produce charcoal. Therefore, it is an example of secondary chemical fuel. Similarly, the various fractions which are obtained from the crude oil, such as petrol, diesel, kerosene, therefore, they are called secondary chemical fuels. And water gas, producer gas also are obtained by passing steam or inert gas on the heated coke or the production of oil gas from kerosene oil. So, they are derived from the primary fuels. Therefore, they are called secondary fuels. What are the requisites of good chemical fuels? The requisites are, they should have a high calorific value, which is abbreviated as capital C, capital V. They should possess a high carbon content. They should have a low moisture content. They should have a low volatile matter content. They should have a low ash content. They should have a moderate ignition temperature. They should burn clean. They should not produce smoke. They should not burn with a long flame. They could be transported easily. They could be operated easily. So these are the requisites of a good chemical fuel. What is calorific value and what are its types? Calorific value is defined as the amount of heat liberated when a unit quantity of fuel is burnt completely, and it is of two types: higher calorific value or gross calorific value, abbreviated as HCV or GCV, and lower calorific value or net calorific value, abbreviated as LCV or NCV. The units of calorific value are kilojoules per kilogram, calories per gram, kilocalories per kilogram. Define higher calorific value and lower calorific value. So again, there are two parts in this question. Definition of higher calorific value and lower calorific value, both are asked. So you will define higher calorific value as the amount of heat liberated when a unit quantity of fuel is burnt completely and the products of combustion are cool down to room temperature. The units already we have discussed: kilojoules per kg, calories per gram, kilocalories per gram. And the definition of lower calorific value is, it is the amount of heat liberated when a unit quantity of fuel is burnt completely and the products of combustion are allowed to escape. This is the reason the value of lower calorific value is always less than the HCV. And we can calculate LCV as HCV minus 0.09 H multiplied by latent heat of steam. Because it is allowed to escape, therefore it takes away with it the latent heat of steam. And this is the reason The lower calorific value is always less than the HCV. What is the apparatus employed to determine the calorific value of a solid fuel or a non-volatile liquid fuel? It is the bomb calorimeter which is employed to determine the calorific value of a solid or a non-volatile liquid fuel. I have already described the bomb calorimeter in one of my videos. Please refer the work in construction of bomb calorimeter in that video. I'll give the link in this video in the comment box, in the description box. How you will determine the calorific value of a gaseous fuel? Boyle's gas calorimeter is used to determine the calorific value of a gaseous fuel or a volatile liquid. What is the significance of calorific value? Calorific value is of great significance because with the help of calorific value, we can qualify the quality of the fuel. And this is the reason we should determine the calorific value of the fuel. I have taken many questions and I have told how to write the answers appropriately. We'll be discussing more questions on many other chapters too. Keep watching and take care of yourself. Bye.